I can see
how
many people. Six people here. I think more people are still joining, right?
Yes.
Okay. While they are joining, let me set up. Something is going on here. I think I've been signed out. My account. Should I start? How many more people are joining?
I think you can start, so they'll join us.
Okay. I've signed out of my account. So my session will actually be very brief because of two reasons. First, I'm running on a very low battery right now. And second, I have another engagement very soon. But I'm actually honored to be here, you know, to give this talk to you. And, you know, I presume some of you are beginners in tech, and I hope that this presentation will help you, you know, build better and more performant web applications. So yeah, as you can see, okay, my screen is still loading.
Yep.
But the title of my tech talk is Creating Magic with Progressive Web Apps. You know, the theme of this IWD program is Courage to Create. So I want to dare you to, you know, create better apps. It's not just about, you know, building web apps. It's about building web apps that perform well, that are fast, that are easily accessible by everybody, you know. That is the essence of this software that we are doing. It's not just building, it is building quality, you know, quality applications. So that's what I'm going to talk about today. And my niche is progressive web apps. So let's start by asking or defining what a progressive web app is. So I have a question. Have you ever visited a website and you get this prompt that says, do you want to install this app on your home screen? I want answers. Have you ever visited a website and you get a prompt that says, do you want to install this website on your home screen?
Yes.
You have, Abby? All right.
Yes.
That is a progressive web app. That app is no longer just a web app. It is a progressive web app. It is an app that allows you to, you know, install that particular application on your device, especially your phones, you know, such that it catches or catches all of your files, all of the files that are in that application, so that the next time you are visiting the application, it's so much faster. You realize that the speed at which you can visit different applications, really different pages, especially pages that you visited before, is so much faster. That is a progressive web app. A progressive web app, like I defined in my slide, is an app that can be reached by users, that second paragraph, that can be reached by users in very developed countries with fast internet connections, and also users in underdeveloped areas with very limited internet connection. For instance, somebody in Korea is using your application and is having the best experience. The same application is being used by somebody in Nigeria, because I hope in Nigeria is not all that developed, and is also having the best experience using your application. So first paragraph says, PWA, that is short form for Progressive Web App, use progressive enhancement to load the most important content first, then add presentational and functional extras as required, meaning that all your users get the same core experience, like I said, as quickly as possible. As quickly as possible is actually the most important aspect of making your app a progressive web app. The speed, the performance, very, very important. So now, how do you switch a normal web app to a progressive web app? That is an application that is built normally with React, for instance. I'm a React developer, so I'll most likely be using React as an example in my slide. If you build an application with React, for instance, how do you make that application, that simple application, become a progressive web app? Usually, you don't have to do any restructuring, any rewriting. You don't have to build from scratch. No, you can use that same web app to switch to a progressive web app only by adding a few layers. It's actually pretty simple. Now, I actually listed all the steps here, but for some reason, it did not save and it logged me out of my account. But let's go. These are the steps involved in switching your web app to your progressive web app. Number one, make sure you are using HTTPS. What is HTTPS? A secure exchange of requests over an HTTP server. Secure being the keyword. Make sure you are using not HTTP, but HTTPS, a secure connection on the HTTP server. Secondly, I want to arrange it in order. Oh gosh, I actually listed all these things, but they didn't save. Oh, thank God. It's back. Oh, I didn't even mention the HTTPS. Okay, I mentioned it now. Make sure you're using HTTPS for your web application. Secondly, create your app shell. What is an app shell? Like I said, I'm a React developer, so I'll be using React as an example. React is a JavaScript framework. Hope we all know that. React is a JavaScript framework. It's also JavaScript, but it's a framework such that you don't need to do all of the installations or configuration from scratch. It has its own folder structure and other things that make it easier for you to build the application. React is just one of the JavaScript frameworks we have. We have Vue.js as well. We have AngularJS as well. But I personally use React. So secondly, now create your app shell. What is an app shell? In React.js, your app shell is your entry file. And your entry file is your app.js in your root folder or in your source folder, depending on how your structure is built. Now, this entry folder enables the user or enables you to give easy access to the user when they are visiting your application. Instead of them, when they visit, for instance, whose name should I use? Okay, Fairomi Adeniji. When I visit fairomiadeniji.com, for instance, now, instead of me to be greeted with a blank page that keeps loading and loading and loading, this is my entry file. My entry file displays first, and in your entry file, it's better to use your CSS inline in your HTML. Actually, if you're not using a framework, for instance, if you're just to use your CSS inline, when you use inline CSS, it makes your application much faster to load. But like I was saying, the app.js is an entry file in your React application. Make sure you have an entry file in your application such that when the user visits your application, there's a page that greets them first, instead of having to load and load and load and load, continuously like that for some minutes. It's bad experience when a user visits your application and it keeps loading blank page like that for minutes. It's very bad user experience. Secondly, in creating your progressive web app, you should have a service worker. In fact, that's the most important file in your creating a PWA. You should have your service worker file. Your service worker is where you have all your configurations, all your caching, all your offline services, configurations, everything that you need to configure your PWA is majorly in your service worker file. Also, I hope this thing is not blocking. Also, in your web application, you should add your push notifications. What is a push notification? A push notification is, I can be using WhatsApp now, for instance, chatting with my friend, and a notification from your website, maybe an e-commerce app, pops up on my phone and says, you have successfully checked out and your product is being shipped at the moment. Something like that. That's a push notification. It just pops up no matter what app you have currently open on your phone. That's a push notification. It's also very good for user experience, right? Then add a web app manifest. Let me talk about this number five, the install prompt. The install prompt is customizable, right? And you customize it according to what you want. It's pretty flexible. So you can say, I want the install prompt, that is that prompt that comes up and says, do you want to install this on your home screen? That prompt, that's what I'm talking about, that install prompt. You can set it to pop up at the time that you want. You can configure that also. I want you to also do your research. I can't say all of these things extensively. So I want you to do your research for switching a web application to a progressive web application. So in your install prompt, you're the one that will configure it and say, okay, I want this prompt to pop up after my user has visited my website three times or four times or five times. Do you understand? So as opposed to a native application, that is Android application, that you have to compulsorily install on first visit. That is the difference between a native app and a progressive web app. In a progressive web app, the prompt might not pop up immediately. It can be on the third visit. It can be on the fourth visit. On the third or fourth user visit. That's when the user is visiting your application. Then you can also configure it to display when they do a particular action. for example, an e-commerce app now, when they click checkout, you can say, display that prompt. Do you understand? So you can configure that install prompt to suit yourself. You know, it's very flexible, like I said. Now, the sixth point is Lighthouse. Lighthouse is very important in, is a very important tool in checking the performance of your website. You know, like I said, it's not just about building web applications. It's about building web applications that are fast and at and that have high performance, right? And Lighthouse is a very good app for you know, auditing your speed and your performance in your application. So that is the last step in, you know, switching from a web app to a progressive app. I want you to also do your research. I want you to, you know, make progressive web applications a norm now. You know, your main goal when you are building your applications should be speed and performance. Speed, how fast is my app? How can somebody that is using 2G, you're not supposed to use 2G. It's somebody that is using 2G. Can the person easily, you know, access my application? Can the person still use my application? Your goal should be, this application should be accessible to anyone, everyone, no matter their region, no matter their internet speed. Do you understand? That should be your goal when you are creating your web applications. My next slide, okay, career nuggets. Now, I see a lot of people building amazing stuff. I see people building amazing stuff, you know, and this is especially for my ladies. Many of my female friends that I know that are in tech are doing amazing stuff, but how many people are really seeing this amazing stuff that you're building? Right? This is outside of PWA now. I just want to, you know, talk to you about your career in general. So I want you to start making intentional steps, you know, to building your career. Start building projects. Build a lot of projects, whether you have a 9-to-5, whether you are still a student, whether you are still, you know, trying to figure out this tech thing. While you are waiting for that your dream job, build many projects, you know. And like I said, web apps with app, not just any kind of project, projects that when people check it out, they'll be like, wow, you know, projects that are standard speed and performance wise. Also, build a portfolio. After you have built your project, you need a platform to showcase your project. And your portfolio should be the best, you know, best bet to showcase your project, because a portfolio is like a website. You can be somewhere and somebody's asking, how many projects have you built? Let me see your works, you know, unprepared. But because you have a portfolio, www.feromiadeniji.com, you can easily showcase that portfolio to the person at that instant, even though you are unprepared. That's the essence of a portfolio. You can carry it anywhere you go. You understand? Because sometimes you can, you know, you might not be able to take your laptop to where you are going to. Please, I need feedback, because network still. Can you people still hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
All right, cool. So, I thought this session would be all ladies do. But it's nice to see the guys too.
Yeah.
So, also, showcase your work. And in showcasing, I'm not talking about your portfolio. I'm talking of social media showcasing on Facebook, join tech communities. Join quality tech communities where you can also showcase your work on Slack. You know, put yourself out there. I've noticed that a lot of us females don't do that. You know, we just do our amazing things and we just show our friends, see what I built, it's really nice. And that is it. You need to start putting yourself out there to get, you know, the right connections, right? Then have a very strong belief in yourself too. That is very important because I understand how imposter syndrome can be, you know, our enemy sometimes. You need to believe that in the first place that you can actually do it, that you are capable of, you know, winning in this tech world. And, you know, that will be your drive, that there's nothing you cannot do. There's nothing, easy React, there's nothing I cannot learn. I can learn React, I can learn database, SQL, my SQL, I can learn backend technologies. I can be great at this web development thing. You need to, you know, constantly, you know, have that belief of yourself. And that's the first, you know, to me, that's the first, you know, way to overcome imposter syndrome. That's pretty much all I would say. And that brings me to the end of my presentation. Thank you so much, everyone. I hope that you've learned a thing or two. I don't know if I'm taking questions though. Am I taking questions?
Yes, we can take questions.
Okay. I'm not really familiar with Zoom. Okay, let me just stop sharing. So any questions? If you cannot unmute, you can
drop them
in the chat.
Okay, hello, can you hear me?
Yes, hello. We can hear you, go ahead.
Can you hear me, please?
I don't know if Tomisin can hear you. Tomisin, can you hear me?
All right, so you're talking about PWA. Okay, so you're talking about PWA and you told us about the advantage. Is there any other like disadvantages of using PWA for your website? Any at all?
Hello, Tomisin. I don't know if she can hear us. Is she here?
Hello, do you get that?
Yeah, but I don't think she's hearing you. I don't know if she's...
Any question?
Yes, someone is asking a question. I think she's having a lag.
Jafar, my battery is still...
Yeah, someone is asking a question. I don't know if you can hear him.
He's still up.
Hello, Tomisin.
Nobody is responding. Can you guys still hear me?
Yes, but
we can hear you.
Okay, I don't know who asked the question. Michael, right?
Yes.
Okay, can you write down the question? Maybe I don't know if she's having a lag or something is up with that.
Okay.
Just put it up on the chat.
I'll do that.
Yeah. So she can follow up probably during the panel session. Okay. What are the odds of using PWA? Okay. So I just pin that down. Oh, where's this thing? Okay, so we are expected to be we're expected to be back to the main room by 12:15. So once you I think we're done. And is there any other questions? So we can just take all of them together and then they're gonna be answered in the break general session. So does anyone else have a question? Okay. All right. So does anyone else have a question? If you have a question, you can just unmute yourself, then ask the question. Okay, in the absence of no more question, we can all leave to the general room. That was just be like 5 minutes earlier. So yeah, we can all leave to the general room and wait the next 5 minutes. Okay. Hey guys. Okay. I try to assess. ourselves to the element. So this is it. That's it. That's one of the things I did. One thing I did was that one at the study yesterday at work. I guess it was a big service. Okay. Well, we can all join the general room. The general class will be starting now. This is 12:15 already, if you can hear me. So I'm just trying to cut time.
Section now to continue with this program. Thank you so much. Yeah. Okay. Bye. Right.